Chapter 2 Biological Classification. Since the dawn of civilization, there have been many attempts to classify living organisms. It was done instinctively, not using criteria that were scientific, but born out of a need to use organisms for our own use, for food, shelter, and clothing. Aristotle was the earliest to attempt a more scientific basis for classification. He used simple morphological characters to classify plants into trees, shrubs, and herbs. He also divided animals into two groups, those which had red blood and those that did not. In Linnaeus' time, a two-kingdom system of classification with Plantae and Animalia kingdom was developed and that included all plants and animals respectively. This system did not distinguish between the eukaryotes and the prokaryotes, unicellular and multicellular organisms, and photosynthetic green algae and non-photosynthetic fungi organisms. Classification of organisms into plants and animals was easily done and was easy to understand, but a large number of organisms did not fall into either category. Hence, the two-kingdom classification used for a long time was found inadequate. Besides gross morphology, a need was also felt for including other characteristics like cell structure, nature of wall, mode of nutrition, habitat, methods of reproduction, evolutionary relationships, etc. Classification system for the living organism have hence undergone several changes over the time. Though plant and animal kingdoms have been a constant under all different systems, the understanding of what group of organisms be included under these kingdoms have been changing. The number and nature of other kingdoms have also been understood differently by different scientists over the time. R. H. Whittaker in 1969 proposed a five-kingdom classification. The kingdom defined by him were named Monera, Protista, Fungi, Plantae, and Animalia. The main criteria for classification used by him includes cell structure, body organization, mode of nutrition, reproduction, and phylogenetic relationships. Table 2.1 gives a comparative account of different characteristics of the five kingdoms. The three-domain system has also been proposed that divides the kingdom Monera into two domains, leaving the remaining eukaryotic kingdom in the third domain and thereby a six-kingdom classification. You will learn about this in detail at higher classes. Let us look at five-kingdom classification to understand the issues and considerations that influence the classification system. Earlier, classification system included bacteria, blue-green algae, fungi, mosses, ferns, gymnosperm, and angiosperm under plants. The character that unified this whole kingdom was that all the organisms included had a cell wall in their cells. This placed together groups which widely differed in other characteristics. It brought together the prokaryotic bacteria and the blue-green algae cyanobacteria with other groups which were eukaryotic. It also grouped together the unicellular organism and the multicellular one. Say for example, Chlamydomonas and Spirogyra were placed together under algae. The classification did not differentiate between the heterotrophic group fungi and autotrophic green plants, though they also showed a characteristic difference in their cell wall composition. The fungi had chitin in their wall, while the green plant had a cellulosic cell wall. When such characteristics were considered, fungi were placed in a separate kingdom, kingdom fungi. All prokaryotic organisms were grouped together under kingdom Monera, and the unicellular eukaryotic organism were placed in kingdom Protista. Kingdom Protista has brought together Chlamydomonas, Chlorella, earlier placed in algae within plants and both having cell wall, with Paramecium and Amoeba, which were earlier placed in the animal kingdom which lack cell wall. It has put together organisms which in earlier classification were placed in different kingdoms. This happened because the criteria for classification changed. This kind of changes will take place in future too, depending on the improvement in our understanding of characteristics and evolutionary relationships. Over time, an attempt has been made to evolve a classification system which reflects not only the morphological, physiological, and reproductive similarities, but is also phylogenetic, that is, based on evolutionary relationships. In this chapter, we will study characteristics of kingdom Monera, Protista, and fungi of the Whittaker system of classification. The kingdom Plantae and Animalia, commonly referred to as plant and animal kingdoms respectively, will be dealt separately in chapter 3 and 4. 2.1 Kingdom Monera. Bacteria are the sole member of kingdom Monera. They are most abundant microorganism. Bacteria occur almost everywhere. Hundreds of bacteria are present in a handful of soil. They also live in extreme habitats such as hot spring, desert, snow, and deep ocean where very few other life forms can survive. Many of them live in or on other organisms as parasites. Bacteria are grouped under four categories based on their shape: the spherical coccus, the rod-shaped bacillus, the comma-shaped vibrium, and the spiral spirillum. Though the bacterial structure is very simple, they are very complex in behavior. Compared to many other organisms, bacteria as a group show the most extensive metabolic diversity. Some of the bacteria are autotrophic, that is, they synthesize their own food from organic substrate. They may be photosynthetic, autotrophic, or chemosynthetic autotrophic. The vast majority of bacteria are heterotrophs, that is, they depend on other organisms or on dead organic matter for food. 2.1.1 Archaebacteria. These bacteria are special since they live in some of the most harsh habitat, such as extreme salty areas, halophiles, hot spring, thermoacidophiles, and marshy areas, methanogen. Archaebacteria differ from other bacteria in having different cell wall structure, and this feature is responsible for their survival in extreme condition. Methanogen are present in the gut of several ruminant animals such as cows and buffaloes, and they are responsible for the production of methane, biogas, from the dung of these animals. 2.1.2 Eubacteria. There are thousands of different Eubacteria or true bacteria. They are characterized by the presence of rigid cell wall and, if motile, a flagellum. The cyanobacteria, also referred to as blue-green algae, have chlorophyll A similar to green plants and are photosynthetic autotrophs. The cyanobacteria are unicellular, colonial, or filamentous, freshwater, marine, or terrestrial algae. The colonies are generally surrounded by gelatinous sheath. They often form blooms in the polluted water body. Some of these organisms can fix atmospheric nitrogen in specialized cell called heterocyst, for example, nostoc and anabena. Chemosynthetic autotrophic bacteria oxidize various inorganic substances such as nitrate, nitrites, and ammonia, and use the released energy for their ATP production. They play a great role in recycling nutrients like nitrogen, phosphorus, iron, and sulfur. Heterotrophic bacteria are the most abundant in nature. The majority are important decomposers. Many of them have significant impact on human affairs. They are helpful in making curd from milk, production of antibiotic, fixing nitrogen in the legume roots, etc. Some are pathogen, causing damage to human beings, crops, farm animals, and pets. Chlorella, typhoid, tetanus, citrus canker are well-known diseases caused by different bacteria. Bacteria reproduce mainly by fission. Sometimes, under unfavorable conditions, they produce spores. They also reproduce by a sort of sexual reproduction by adopting a primitive type of DNA transfer from one bacteria to the other. The mycoplasma are organisms that completely lack a cell wall. They are smallest living cells known and can survive without oxygen. Many mycoplasma are pathogenic in animals and plants. 2.2 Kingdom Protista. All single-celled eukaryotes are placed under Protista, but the boundaries of this kingdom are not well defined. What may be a photosynthetic protistian to one biologist may be a plant to another. In this book, we include Christophyte, dinoflagellates, euglenoid, slime mold, and protozoans under Protista. Members of Protista are primarily aquatic. This kingdom forms a link with others dealing with plants, animals, and fungi. Being eukaryotes, the Protista cell body contains a well-defined nucleus and other membrane-bound organelles. Some have flagella or cilia. Protists reproduce asexually and sexually by process involving cell fusion and zygote formation. 2.2.1 Christophytes. This group includes diatom and golden algae desmids. They are found in fresh water as well as in marine environment. They are microscopic and float passively in water current or plankton. Most of them are photosynthetic. In diatoms, the cell wall form two thin overlapping shell which fit together as in a soap box. The walls are embedded with silica and thus the walls are indestructible. Thus, diatoms have left behind a large amount of cell wall deposits in their habitat. This accumulation over billions of years is referred to as micaceous earth. Being gritty, this soil is used in polishing, filtration of oil and syrups. Diatoms are the chief producer in the ocean. 2.2.2 Dinoflagellates. These organisms are mostly marine and photosynthetic. They appear yellow, green, brown, blue, or red depending on the main pigments present in their cell. The cell wall has stiff cellulose plate on the outer surface. Most of them have two flagella, one lies longitudinally and other transversely in a furrow between wall plates. Very often, red dinoflagellate, for example gynoclocks, undergo such rapid multiplication that they make sea appear red, which is known as red tides. Toxin released by such large number may even kill other marine animals such as fishes. 2.2.3 Euglenoid. Majority of them are freshwater organisms found in stagnant water. Instead of a cell wall, they have a protein-rich layer called pellicle which makes their body flexible. They have two flagella, a short and a long one. Though they are photosynthetic in the presence of sunlight, when deprived of sunlight, they behave like heterotroph by predating on other smaller organisms. Interestingly, the pigments of euglenoid are identical to those pigments in the higher plant, like in euglena. 2.2.4 Slime molds. Slime molds are saprophytic protists. The body moves along decaying twigs and leaves engulfing organic material. Under suitable condition, they form an aggregation called plasmodium, which may grow and spread over several feet. During unfavorable condition, the plasmodium differentiates and form fruiting bodies bearing spores at their tips. The spore possesses true walls. They are extremely resistant and survive for many years, even under adverse condition. The spores are dispersed by air currents. 2.2.5 Protozoan. All protozoans are heterotroph and live as predator or parasite. They are believed to be primitive relatives of animals. There are major four groups of protozoan. Amoeboid protozoan. These organisms live in fresh water, sea water, or moist soil. They move and capture their prey by putting out pseudopodia, that is false feet, as in amoeba. The marine forms have silica shell on their surface. Some of them, such as anti-amoeba, are parasite. Flagellated protozoan. The member of these groups are either free-living or parasitic. They have flagella. The parasitic form causes diseases such as sleeping sickness, example trypanosoma. Ciliated protozoan. These are aquatic, actively moving organisms. Because of the presence of thousands of cilia, they have a cavity or gullet that opens to the outside of the cell surface. The coordinated movement of rows of cilia causes the water laden with food to be steered into the gullet. Example, paramecium. Sporozoan. These include This include diverse organisms that have infectious spore-like stage in their life cycle. The most notorious is Plasmodium, malarial parasite which causes malaria. 2.3 Kingdom Fungi. Fungi constitute a unique kingdom of heterotrophic organisms. They show a great variety in morphology and habitat. You must have seen fungi on moist bread and rotten fruit. The common mushroom you eat and toadstools are also fungi. White spots seen on mustard leaves are due to parasitic fungus. Some unicellular fungi like yeast are used to make bread and beer. Other fungi cause diseases in plants and animals. Wheat rust causing pecunia is an important example. Some are the source of antibiotic, for example, penicillin. Fungi are cosmopolitan and occur in air, water, soil and on animals and plants. They prefer to grow in warm and humid places. Have you ever wondered why we keep food in refrigerator? Yes, it is to prevent food from going bad due to bacterial or fungal infection. With the exception of yeast, which are unicellular, fungi are filamentous. Their body consists of long, slender, thread-like structures called hyphae. The network of hyphae is known as mycelium. Some hyphae are continuous tube filled with multinucleated cytoplasm. These are called cenocytic hyphae. Others have septae or cross walls in their hyphae. The cell walls of fungi are composed of chitin and polysaccharide. Most fungi are heterotrophic and absorb soluble organic matter from dead substrate and hence are called saprophytes. Those that depends on living plants and animals are called parasites. They can also live as symbionts in association with algae as lichen and with roots of higher plants like mycorrhiza. Reproduction in fungi can take place by vegetative means, fragmentation, fission and budding. Asexual reproduction is by spores called conidia or sporangiospores or zoospores, and sexual reproduction is by oospore, ascospore and basidiospore. The various spores are produced in distinct structure called fruiting bodies. The sexual cycle involves the following three steps. Number one, the fusion of protoplasms between two motile or non-motile gamete called plasmogamy, fusion of two nuclei called karyogamy, meiosis in zygote resulting in a diploid spore. When a fungus reproduces sexually, two haploid hyphae of compatible mating types come together and fuse. In some fungi, the fusion of two haploid cells immediately result in diploid cell 2N. However, in other fungi, ascomycetes and basidiomycetes, an intervening dikaryotic stage, that is two nuclei per cell, occurs. Such a condition is called dikaryon and a phase is called dikaryophase of fungus. Later, the parental nuclei fuse and the cells become diploid. The fungi form fruiting bodies in which reduction division occurs, leading to formation of haploid spores. The morphology of the mycelium, mode of spore formation and fruiting bodies form the basis of division of the kingdom into various classes. 2.3.1 Phycomycetes. Members of Phycomycetes are found in aquatic habitat on decaying wood in moist and damp places or as obligate parasite on plants. The mycelium is aseptate and cenocytic. Asexual reproduction takes place by zoospore, which is motile, or by aplanospore, which are non-motile. These spores are endogenously produced in sporangium. A zygospore is formed by fusion of two gametes. These gametes are similar in morphology, isogamous or dissimilar in anisogamous or oogamous. Some common examples are mucor, rhizopus, the bread mold mentioned earlier, and albugo, the parasitic fungi on mustard. 2.3.2 Ascomycetes. commonly known as sac fungi, the ascomycetes are mostly multicellular, for example penicillin, or rarely unicellular like yeast, Saccharomyces. These are saprophytic, decomposer, parasitic, or coprophilous, growing on dung. Mycelium is branched and septate. The asexual spore are conidia, produced exogenously on the special mycelium called conidiophore. Conidia on germination produce mycelium. Sexual spore are called ascospores, which are produced endogenously in sac-like asci, singular ascus. These asci are arranged in different types of fruiting body called ascocarps. Some examples are Aspergillus, Claviceps, and Neurospora. Neurospora is used extensively in biochemical and genetic work. Many members like morel and truffle are edible and are considered delicacies. 2.3.3 Basidiomycetes. Commonly known form of Basidiomycetes are mushrooms, bracket fungi, or puffball. They grow in soil on logs and tree stumps and in living plant bodies as parasites, for example, rust and smuts. The mycelium is branched and septate. The asexual spores are generally not found, but vegetative reproduction by fragmentation is common. The sex organs are absent. Plasmogamy is brought by fusion of two vegetative or somatic cells of different strain or genotypes. The resultant structure is dikaryotic, which ultimately gives rise to basidium. Karyogamy and meiosis take place in the basidium, producing four basidiospores. The basidiospores are exogenously produced on basidium. The basidia are arranged in fruiting bodies called basidiocarps. Some common members are agaricus, mushroom, astilagos, smut, and picunia, rust fungus. 2.3.4 Deuteromycetes. Commonly known as imperfect fungi because only the asexual or vegetative phases of these fungi are known. When the sexual forms of these fungi were discovered, they were moved into classes they rightly belong to. It is also possible that the sexual and vegetative stage have been given one name and placed under Deuteromycetes, sexual stage another and placed under another class. Later, when the linkage were established, the fungi were correctly identified and moved out of Deuteromycetes. One perfect sexual stage of members of Deuteromycetes were discovered. They were moved to Ascomycetes and Basidiomycetes. The Deuteromycetes reproduce only bisexual spore known as conidia. The mycelium is septate and branched. Some members are saprophytes or parasite, while large number of them are decomposer of litter and help in mineral cycling. Some examples are Alternaria, Coletotrichum, and Trichoderma. 2.4 Kingdom Plantae. Kingdom Plantae. Kingdom Plantae includes all eukaryotic chlorophyll-containing organism commonly called plants. The few members are partially heterotrophic, such as insectivorous plants or parasite. Bladderwort and Venus flytrap are example of insectivorous plants, and Cuscusta is a parasite. The plant cell have an eukaryotic structure with prominent chloroplast and cell wall, mainly made up of cellulose. You will study the eukaryotic cell structure in detail in chapter 8. Plantae include algae, bryophyte, pteridophyte, gymnosperm, and angiosperm. Life cycle of plant has two distinct phases, the diploid sporophytic and the haploid gametophytic, that alternate with each other. The length of haploid and diploid phases and whether these phases are free living or dependent on other vary among different group in plants. This phenomena is called alternation of generation. You will study further detail of this kingdom in chapter 3. 2.5 Kingdom Animalia. This kingdom is characterized by heterotrophic eukaryotic organisms that are multicellular and their cell lack cell walls. They directly or indirectly depend on plant for food. They digest their food in an internal cavity and store food reserves as glycogen or fat. Their mode of nutrition is holozoic, by ingestion of food. They follow a definite growth pattern and grow into adults that have a definite shape and size. Higher forms show elaborate sensory and neuromotor mechanism. Most of them are capable of locomotion. The sexual reproduction is by copulation of male and female followed by embryological development. Silent features of various phyla are described in chapter 4. 2.6. Virus, viroids, prion and lichen. In Five Kingdom classification of Whittaker, there is no mention of lichen and some acellular organisms like virus, viroids and prions. These are briefly introduced here. All of us who have suffered the ill effect of common cold or flu know what effect virus can have on us, even we do not associate it with our condition. Viruses did not find place in classification since they are not considered truly living. If we understand living as those organisms that have cell structure, the viruses are non-cellular organisms that are characterized by having an inert crystalline structure outside the living cell. Once they affect a cell, they take over the machinery of the host cell to replicate themselves, killing the host. Would you call virus living or non-living? The name virus, that means venom or poisonous fluid, was given by Dmitry Ivanovsky. Recognized certain microbes as causal organism of the mosaic disease of tobacco. They were found to be smaller than bacteria because they pass through bacteria-proof filter. M.W. Bejerinck demonstrated that the extract of infected plant of tobacco could cause infection in healthy plant and called the fluid as infectious living fluid. W.M. Stanley showed that viruses could be crystallized and crystals consist largely of protein. They are inert outside their specific host cell. Viruses are obligate parasite. In addition to proteins, viruses also contain genetic material that could be either RNA or DNA. No virus contain both RNA and DNA. A virus is a nucleoprotein and genetic material is infectious. In general, viruses that infect plant have single-stranded RNA, and viruses that infect animals have either single or double-stranded RNA or double-stranded DNA. Bacterial viruses or bacteriophages, viruses that infect the bacteria, are usually double-stranded DNA viruses. The protein called capsid, made up of small subunit called capsomeres, protects the nucleic acid. These capsomeres are arranged in helical or polyhedral geometric form. Viruses cause diseases like mumps, smallpox, herpes, and influenza. AIDS in human is also caught by virus. In plants, the symptoms can be mosaic formation, leaf rolling and curling, yellowing and vein clearing, dwarfing and stunted growth. Voroid. In 1971, T.O. Diner discovered a new infectious agent that were smaller than viruses and caused potato spindle tuber disease. It was found to be a free RNA. It lacked the protein coat that is found in viruses, hence the name viroid. The RNA of the viroid was of low molecular weight. Prion. In modern medicine, certain infectious neurological diseases were found to be transmitted by an agent consisting of abnormally folded protein. The agent was similar in size to virus. These agents were called prion. The most notable disease caused by prion are mad cow disease in cattle and is analogous variant of CR-Jacob disease, CJD, in human. Lichen. Lichen are symbiotic association, that is mutually useful association between algae and fungi. The algal component is known as phycobiont and the fungal component as mycobiont, which are autotrophic and heterotrophic respectively. Algae prepare food for fungi, and fungi provide shelter and absorb mineral nutrients and water for its partner. So close is their association that if one saw a lichen in nature, one would never imagine that they had two different organisms without them. Lichen are very good population indicator. They do not grow in polluted area.